I asked his partner. loved ones, and it is also the season for reflection and gratitude. I know each one of us could easily come up with 125 things that we are grateful for at CSG in honor of our quasquam centennial. Sisterhood, scholarship, service, spirit, and so much more. As I reflected on this milestone year for our school, I thought I'd take a moment to share with you some of the special things I hold in my heart when I think about our school's legacy and what it means to me. When I think about what I'm grateful for at CSG, I start with our founders, Mary Bowles Scott and Florence Kelly. Our rich and storied history would not have been possible without their efforts to lay the foundation for our school to be an unparalleled center for excellence that it is today. In fact, we were just recently named the number one private school in Columbus by Columbus CEO Best of Business. For 125 years, we have executed our mission of empowering girls to discover their distinct potential as learners and leaders. And we have helped five generations of girls and women find their voice and know their power. Our graduates are a testament to the life-changing benefits of attending a girls' school, and we are fiercely dedicated to educating and empowering the next generation of change makers. Our theme for this year, An Anchored Legacy for a Bold Future, is meant to underscore the celebration of our legacy and our bold enthusiasm for the path ahead. We celebrate and recognize our history as a community by design, a rich tapestry of teachers, coaches, administrators, students, staff, alumni, families, community partners, and so many more. I am grateful for every one of you and your unique role in making CSG what it is today. CSG's success would not be possible without those of you who tirelessly give of your time and your talents as volunteers across the school. Our Board of Trustees, our Parents Association, those who run the Unicorner store, our form parents, our soup-serving volunteers at lunch, those of you who sweep up after the BYC lunch, and the alumni who visit our classrooms to work with our students are just some of the examples of the many groups of people who help us work every day to ensure our girls find and know their power. We are grateful for you, for your gift of your treasure to the community, of supporters who believe in the power of a CSG education. Your generosity plays a critical role in helping CSG carry out our mission today and for generations to come. Your giving ensures that we continue to make our programming accessible for girls and young women of great promise across Central Ohio. And they make initiatives like the Institute for Innovation and Leadership and campus improvements like our Learning Garden, our updated Power Library, and our turf field possible. Our students benefit from an unparalleled collection of arenas for learning, creativity, and self-expression. From our PYC studio to our innovation lab to the Agnes Jeffrey Shedd Theater, there are so many places across our three campuses that hold a special place in our hearts. How many senior screens have rung out from our Cinderella stairs? And how many pairs of feet have traversed forest trails and splashed through creek beds at Cynthia's Woods? The memories we hold and the traditions we share are the ties that bind us together. Red and gold team games during pep rallies and Big Little Sis events, Spirit Week pajama days, and unit sightings in the hallways are just some of the special parts of what it means to be a member of the CSG community. Our academic year is full of joyful celebrations and reasons to gather, from the scholarship walk to senior day to convocation. We all know that the first day of the month means chicken fingers for lunch, and that Halloween is a time for hearing Mrs. Rufel's scary stories in the mansion basement. Each school year means another one of Mrs. FG's Arctic Tern migrations through the halls of the lower school, and another chance to watch the determination with which our upper school students try to land a raw egg on Dr. Sweeney's head. I continue to be in awe of all of the ways in which our amazing teachers provide our students with the tools and inspiration to make their mark on the world. From Children's Book Week to Senior May program to middle school trips to Washington, D.C. and the OSU Stone Lab, our girls are gaining crucial knowledge, skills, and tools needed to be the leaders of tomorrow. A whole new world of possibilities has opened with the launch of our Institute for Innovation and Leadership. And I want to give a special thanks to our center directors for their work this year to bring a variety of events and programming to fruition. This school year, our students are learning new styles of dance, visiting countries around the world to develop their global citizenship, detailing their research for our upcoming CSG Science Research Journal, and much more thanks to the efforts of our center directors, and they are just getting started. I am grateful to our students, from our youngest learners with their boundless curiosity and energetic exploration, to the class of 2024, with their determination and their leadership. Our students make me proud every day as I watch them learn and lead in small and micro ways the lower school. As a community, they collected more than 10,000 cans for their annual food drive because they are young people who believe in themselves and want to make a difference and understand the power that they have within. There is a really special magic associated with CSG that you won't find anywhere else. And I believe that magic is rooted in sisterhood and in our celebration of the innate potential of girlhood. I am proud of all that our girls can achieve here, free from constraints and from stereotypes. And I'm proud of the ways in which they show up for each other as friends, as leaders, and as strong role models. Finally, I am grateful to all of you today for being here, for joining together in community for one of our most beloved school traditions. Each time we celebrate with each other, we are strengthening connections to each other, to our past, and we are laying the foundation for our future. Today, I challenge all of you to think of the things that you are most grateful for about CSG and in our community, and let's see if you can name more than 125. Now I invite all of you who are able to please stand for our traditional Thanksgiving service. At this time, please welcome Justice Johnson, class of 2024. She will lead us in our responsive reading of an Indigenous Youth Prayer.
Thank you.
traditional Thanksgiving service portion of our program, please join me as we say the school prayer. Watch over our school, Lord, as its years increase. And bless and guide its children wherever they may be. Let their hearts be warm with the flame of your new ideals, their faith unshaken, and their principles immovable. Be thou by their side when the dark hour shall come upon them. Strengthen them when they stand. Comfort and help them when they are weak hearted. Raise them up if they fall. And grant that all may grow up in grace. And in departing from God on this, they serve thee in your presence of living and truth. Amen. At CSG, we are grateful that we're able to offer a program that provides rich experiences to support the whole world. Our students are extraordinary scholars, and they are talented creators. And today, we celebrate their voices and their gifts through song and through speech. We will enjoy a series of gratitude reflections and performances by students representing the entire school. For more than 100 years, CSG's traditional Thanksgiving program has included a heartwarming presentation by our youngest learners in the PYC, as well as musical selections from our school musicians. To begin this portion of our program, we will hear from the Upper School Orchestra playing Majestica. Share why they are thankful at CSG.
Sophia's Woods because it's a place that helps us be brave.
When we visited the woods, we were afraid because some things were unknown.
We're bigger than our creatures, but when you're scared, you can feel small.
When you feel scared, you can brave up.
You have to be scared to be brave.
Maple is beautiful and scary. We can coexist with maple.
Thank you.
twice a week. So I think that while the girls are returning to their seats, you guys did such a great job. So proud of you. That this would be a good moment for everyone to get their waves out. So go ahead and wave at your family, girls, to wave to your people if you see them. We'll get all of our waving out. Our Thanksgiving program has included the sharing of a turkey song by some of our lower school students. Last year, forms 4 and 5 sang about a turkey who just didn't want to get caught, and no one could kill the turkey. This year, as we alternate classes and songs, forms 1, 2, and 3 will sing the story of the dirty turkey. Today, a student representing each form will share her dream with us.
My name is Lucy Browning. My dream for girls around the world is for them to go to school with no barriers in their way.
My name is Lillian Waldo. I'm in Form 2. My dream for girls around the world is for girls to read a lot so they can learn a lot. It is important for girls to have a strong education and to be determined and brave. brave as they pursue their dream. Another dream I have for girls around the world is for girls to be loved for who they are and their skin color. Lastly, it is my dream that girls will have equality.
My name is Dina Kibbutz Stackhouse, and I am in 4th grade. My dream for girls around the world is for them to know and see the power that they have. I also want them to know they don't have to be scared and they can stand up for themselves.
My name is Mary Alice Wolford and I am in 4th form. My dream for girls around the world is for all girls to follow their own path and not to follow the path that someone puts out for them.
My name is Helen Rice. I am in 4th. I hope that girls around the world can experience success and happiness in life. I hope all of us can access a good education, get influences, and respect. One day, I hope there will be equality.
CSG students are not only classmates, they are a part of something greater that will last years beyond their time at CSG. They are a part of a sisterhood. Please welcome Form 8 student Zoe Keeling to share what sisterhood means to her.
Hi everyone, I want to start by welcoming you here today. I am eternally grateful for all CSG has done for me. I have spectacular teachers, amazing classes, opportunities, and once-in-a-lifetime friendships. When writing this speech, we were told to talk about sisterhood. The definition of sisterhood is the relationship between sisters and or an association, society, or community of women linked by a common interest, religion, or trade. Or, as my many aunts would say, who is going to help you bury the body? But if I had to talk about sisterhood, I would talk about a connection, specifically about my class. My class and I have grown together and made memories that I will cherish and remember forever. I have been at CSG for 11 years. For 11 years, I've had the privilege to know remarkable young women and to make wonderful memories. I remember building the treehouse in 4 vibes and how I was so determined to make sure there was a toilet in it. Even during the pandemic, we only grew closer to class. I vividly remember doing 2-minute Zoom meetings with each other in between each class. I also remember, quote unquote, texting each other on Padlet since we did not have phones yet. I have to say, though, one of my all-time favorite memories with my class was our 8th grade retreat. We were told to close our eyes, and when the teachers tapped you, you would stand and open your eyes. The teachers would then say something like, tap somebody who inspires you, or tap somebody who taught you something new. I was tapped by a teacher for the last category. Tap somebody who you are proud of. My classmates and I went around and tapped every single person in our class. I do not think any other story could describe my class better. They say there is family and there is chosen family. My classmates are my chosen family. I don't think anything or anyone will ever change that. I have respect for every single one of them. Some of them are leaders, others are innovators, but all of them are the kindest people you will ever meet. As I was thinking about all of this, I was curious how I ended up being lucky enough to come to CSG. My mother told me the reason she chose this school and not somewhere else. She told me not only was there an incredible education, but she knew I would never be told, you can't do this because you are a girl. Not only that, but she knew at CSG, I would graduate with not one, not two, but with a whole class of ready-made sisters for life. So, what is sisterhood? Maybe sisterhood is the special bond that we as women share, the mutual respect of all women by women. Personally, I think you can't describe sisterhood with just one or two definitions. Let me just say that my years at CSG are some of the happiest of my life, and I cannot imagine a world without my classmates and sisters. Thank you for your time, and have a wonderful day.
Thank you. Marissa Lee and Madeline Hansen.
During the Thanksgiving program, the first thing I found myself asking was, what am I grateful for? This seems like a pretty good and, well, obvious place to start. A few things stuck out to me. The house I live in, the food on my table during every meal, my parents. I knew I was definitely more privileged and fortunate than most kids and even people around the world. So I slept on that thought, feeling pretty confident what I was going to talk about now. Except I didn't fall asleep so soundly that night, like most nights in my life, which left me continuing to reflect on my responses and thoughts. Throughout the night, the longer I thought about it, the more I realized how grateful I was for the more specific things in my life. For example, there's my younger brother, who has made it his life's mission to bug me whenever I'm in sight. And when I say in sight, I seriously mean in sight. It doesn't matter if we're just chilling in the house, out in public, eating at a really, really fancy restaurant, or even in church. He thinks it is perfect for him to annoy me whenever he wishes, while I just suffer the consequences and embarrassment. But despite all those times of bewilderment, I feel grateful for the smile that forms on his face from his own amusement. His smile, maybe because it's so goofy looking, is always able to put me in a better mood. Whether I've had a really tough day at school or I'm feeling super stressed, his mischievous grin will always be able to brighten my day by even just a little bit more. And as I thought of that, I realized that next year when I inevitably go to college, I won't be able to experience those moments as often anymore. My younger brother will no longer exist in my life the way I was used to. I then recognized that this small thing that I thought didn't affect me very much actually impacts how I'm able to survive and live every day. Sadly, I had taken this little thing for granted, and it's only because I'm about to lose it that it's sticking out to me now. With this in mind, I want to ask you all, what are some of the little things that you all are grateful for? And that isn't to say that the bigger and broader things such as food, shelter, and family are not as important. But I just want to encourage you to take some time to think about things that you could have overlooked. You never know how much something could have affected you until you've lost it. So start appreciating all those little things in your life now before they're gone and it's too late.
I also started with broad questions about gratitude and then narrowed it down to specifically, what does it mean to be grateful? A dictionary definition will tell you that gratitude is rooted in a strong feeling of appreciation to someone or something for what they have done to help you. When I think about the people who have helped me, I think about all the incredible people here at CSG and how without CSG, I would not have made memorable experiences with all these people. There are so many people and opportunities within these walls that can be easily overlooked each day. For instance, if I didn't attend CSG, would I be as grateful for all my teachers and administrators' amazing education and guidance? From our academic teachers over the last 4 years who have taught us everything from Mandarin phrases to how to take a deep dive into the challenging learning of Beowulf to creating informed citizens of our government. To those who have led us through the process of applying to college, to our division directors who have fostered community between forms, we are supported every step of the way. Would I be as grateful for the amazing athletic and team opportunities available to me?
My fall soccer season is always a highlight of my year, and especially this year, playing with my best friends under the best coaches for the last time is something that I will never forget. Competing on such a close-knit team, spending almost every day together from August to October, through ups and downs, fosters something so special. Would I be as grateful for the wealth of extracurriculars we have available to us? I've become a Gold Key ambassador, a STEM tutor, and a freshman ambassador, things that younger me would have never thought I would do. I've watched the middle and upper school student councils lead their divisions, Silhouette editorial staff finalize amazing newspaper issues, club leaders set up meetings and speak about things they are passionate about, and so much more. And what I'd be is grateful for the incredible people I spend every school day with. Being able to graduate high school with so much to be grateful for does not happen to everyone. Without CSG, I would never have met the amazing class of 2024, and I am grateful for every moment I spend with them. I am grateful that no matter where or when I'm walking the halls of CSG, there's always a smiling face and someone to say hello to.
Things we can do to help others.
So during our break, take time to think about the easily missed and the obvious things. Each person in this room has something to be grateful for, and when you set aside the time, just as Alyssa and I did, I believe you can find more than you imagine. Thank you and have a happy Thanksgiving.
Alyssa and Madeline and all of our student speakers for your wisdom and for your reflections on gratitude this morning. As we continue with our music program, first we will hear the orchestra's playing of a traditional Thanksgiving program favorite, Simple Gifts, followed by our upper school concert choir's performance of Crowded Table.
Thank you.
anniversary year, where we pay homage to the traditions and people that paved the way for us to be right here where we are today. Through the years, thousands of young women have sung this last song together, and today it offers us the perfect opportunity to invite Grace Notes alumni that are with us today to join the Grace Notes at this time as we sing Schoolmates Lift Your Voices. So come on down. I know there are a couple of you here. Please rise and join in the singing of the school song, Schoolmates Lift Your Voices. Thank you. The Unicorner is open for all of your shopping needs. And there is a Kendra Scott pop-up shop for those of you who like a little bling with a special